Today we're going to take a look at a really cool formula solution. It's actually a trick with a new filter function. We're going to use it to return multiple match results from non-adjacent columns based on any logic you need in your analysis. You can also use this to return unique values from non-adjacent columns. It's one single formula that spills and gets the job done for you in record time. In our first example, we want to get a list of names and positions of employees that have a salary that's greater than 100,000. Now we want our results right here, and we want it to be in a dynamic way so that whenever we update this number, our results will automatically update. Our row data is right here, and we have some additional information than what we need. So we also have information on department, start date, and birth date. Now, just for simplicity, I put the data set beside where we're going to do the analysis, but of course, the row data can be on a separate tab as well. Now, my data here goes all the way to line 68. What I'm going to do is to turn this into an official Excel table so that whenever I add new lines to this, my results will also automatically update. So let's do that first. Just go somewhere inside the data set and press Ctrl T. My table has headers. Now I'm just going to take away the formatting and update the name to TSAL for table salary. Now what I want to do here is to use a formula because I want this to be automatic. I don't want to have to press refresh or anything. I want my results to update the moment something changes. This means that I'm going to use the new Microsoft 365 filter function for Excel. Now, if you're not familiar with the filter function, I have a separate video on that. I'm going to add the link to the description of this video, so check that out. In this lecture, we're going to use a trick with that function so that we can return non-adjacent columns. Let's start off by using the traditional filter function first. The first argument is the array. This is the columns that you want returned. What I want returned here is name and position. But check this out, name and position aren't beside one another. And for array, I can just have one range. So I cannot select them individually. What I have to do is select the entire range and also include start date and birth date in there, even though I don't want them in my end result. But we're going to take care of those in a second, so stay with me. The next argument is the include argument. I want to include only the rows where I have a salary number that's greater than this number. So I'm going to highlight salary and greater than this one right here. If you also wanted it to be greater than or equal to, you can add an equal sign here. In this case, I just want to go with the greater than. Last argument in filter is an optional argument. What do you want returned if there are no matches found? So if no one is earning more than 100,000. Well, in this case, I don't need to worry about that because I know I'm going to have a match. So I'm just going to close bracket, press enter, and I get a filtered view of my results that's dynamic. So I get Wolfgang because he earns 116,000. Then I get Paul. These ones are not in my results. And then I get Stevie Bridge right here. Now notice also that I get these two columns. I see them as numbers because they're not formatted as dates. But these are basically my start date and birth date, which I actually don't want because I just want position. So here's what you need to do to filter out what you don't want. Check this out. We're going to use another filter function. The array is basically this, what we see here. Now, what do we want included? Well, for this include argument, I'm going to use array constants. So I'm going to open the curly bracket and I'm going to flag the columns that I want to keep by using ones and zeros. So check this out. In the original array, I selected four columns, right? Now we're going to say what we want to keep. I want to keep the name and I'm going to put a one, comma. I don't want to keep start date and birth date, so I'm going to put a zero, comma, zero, comma. I want to keep the last one. I'm going to put a one and I'm going to close the curly bracket. So in a way, what I'm doing here is I'm broadcasting the one to the values sitting in this column. What the include argument of filter does is it includes values that are true. And for Excel, ones are true and zeros are false. So this is a way that you can flag what you want to keep. Now check this out. I'm going to close the bracket and press enter, and I only get the columns that I want to keep. Now I first saw this from one of my students, Adam, who's in my dynamic array course, and I loved his solution, so I had to share it with you because it's so simple and it's really easy to remember. Just flag the columns that you want to keep. Now in case you want to get this sorted, you can continue and wrap this inside the sort function. By default, it's going to sort based on the first column. So I'm going to close bracket, press enter. I have everything sorted by name. If you wanted to sort by position, you can add the sort index argument here, which is the second argument. So I'm going to put a comma here and sort by the second column. So that's going to sort by position. Now you can use this trick for other things as well. So you could use it to get a unique list for department and position. So basically a unique list of non-adjacent columns. Now let me quickly show you. I'm just going to hide this so we're closer to our data set. The unique function is also one of the new functions that was introduced in 365. It basically returns a distinct list of values. So if I wanted just a distinct list for department, I can select department here, close bracket, and press enter. Now, in the same way, you can get a unique list of more than one column, but they have to be beside one another. So I could return a unique list of department and name. In this case, if they're beside one another, it's no problem. But that's not what I want. I want to get a unique list for department and position right here. The problem is they are in separate columns. Here, I'm going to use the filter trick as well. First, what I'm going to do before using unique is to filter out the columns that I want from my original list. So I'm going to highlight the entire array, and then in the include argument, I'm going to flag the columns that I want to keep. So I want to keep the first one, that's a 1, comma, then 0, 0, 0 for name, start date, and birth date. And last one is for position, I want. So I'm going to put a 1, close bracket, and enter. So now I have department and position. Then I can put this inside my unique function, and I can get a unique list for department and position. Now, if you want to get this sorted, you can put this inside the sort function and sort. In this case, we're going to sort by department, right? So a very simple flagging solution to only include the columns that you want returned. Now, remember I said we want everything to be dynamic. So let's just test for that. Let's unhide this. I'm going to change this to 120,000 and my results update automatically. Now let's also make sure that if we add new lines to this, everything updates as well. So I'm going to add a new legal department and let's just add a consultant for 50,000. Now we shouldn't see this on our first list here, but we should see it here. We see the legal department. And if this person gets a raise and they earn 130,000, we should see Lily right here. As a bonus tip, let's see how we could sort these based on their salary. Here, what I would do is first just filter the information that I need. So let's start out with filter. My array is basically I want name and position, but I'm going to include salary in the first round as well, just so that it's easier for me to sort it. And then I'm going to exclude it from my final result. So that's my array. Next, what I want to include is just like before, I want everything included that is greater than this number here, right? So that's my filtered result. Now everything is going to spill and it's not going to have enough space because I have these in front. So let me just insert some lines just so that we can see our numbers here. And anyhow, we're going to be restricting it to two columns in a second. It's just easier to write the formula if you start from the inside and then go out. Next is to get this sorted by salary. So I'm going to sort. My array is this, and I want to sort it by the last column. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I want it in descending order. So I'm going to put a -1. Close bracket, press enter. Everything is sorted by salary. So Crystal Doyle is first and Stevie Bridge is last. Now I only want included the name and the position. So let's put this now inside our filter trick. That's my array. My include argument are my flags of what I want included. That's 1, then 0 for start date, 0 for birth date, 1 for position, and 0 for salary, because I don't want to show that in my end result. Close bracket, press enter. I have everything sorted in descending order by salary. That's the filter trick you can use to return values based on non-adjacent columns. I love the simplicity of this. If you're also a fan of this solution, do give this video a thumbs up. Now I have a complete course on the new Excel functions where I show you how you can maximize the potential of the new Excel. Check it out if you have Excel for Microsoft 365. Link to it is below. Now before you leave, don't forget to subscribe so you can join our community here and stay up to date with new functionalities. I'm going to see you in the next video.